Hey everyone, it's Rock for Cash, the People's Champ, coming to you live from Cash Stadium, and welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to a review of Week 12 of the FNFL. A week that saw a few upsets and some big scores, so let's get into it. There's no song today, no one's got to me with a song, so we're just going to leave that one blank at this stage. So let's get into what happened in Week number 12 of the FNFL. The first game was Rock for Cash versus Archie's All-Stars. Let me set the scene for you. Rock for Cash in 10th spot up against Archie's All-Stars in first spot. Archie's All-Stars, an evil despot who takes great pride in rogering and abusing altar boys, up against Rock for Cash, the people's champ, the champ who only ever does good for people. This was a good versus evil battle, right down to the wire. And Rock for Cash, the light, 138.4, Archie's All-Stars, 132.36. Rock for Cash prevailing in this one, a great, great win. Came down to Antonio Gibson needing 26 on the final day, only got 20. But for Rock for Cash, Jones from the Patriots got 19, Fournette got 40, Diggs 16, Renfro 21, Gronk 15, and for Archie's All-Stars, Allen got 24, like I said, Gibson got 20, Samuel got 20, Jefferson got 11, Andrews 14, and Johnson 14, and the Dolphins 23, but not enough. Rafa Cash absolutely pumped with this win. This is setting him up for a absolute run at the Duty Bowl now. Absolutely stoked with this win. In the next game, we saw Little Waders hosting Little River Giants in the Little Cup. This time, Little River Giants, 107.88, defeated Little Waders 49.16. So what's that? Nearly a 60-point win to the Giants. Little River Giants, Rogers got 25, Eckler 18, Adams 14, Waddell 24, and the Ravens 13. Not much from Little Waders this week. She obviously has taken an RDO or something. Moore got 12 and Tucker got 12. She doesn't play this bad. So this is just a little blip on the radar, I think. But a great win by Little River Giants and Little Cup. In the next game, the Dark Side took on Young Remix Killers, and the Dark Side prevailed in this one. They did a great job, 91.78 to Young Remix Killers, 75.4. Someone might say this was a bit of an upset, but no, not based on ladder positions. Ladder positions would have had the Dark Side as the favourite going into this game. The Dark Side had Henderson 15, Taylor 17, Cooks 12, Gould 10, and the Bills defence 12. And for Young Remix Killers, Elliott 13, Harris 11, and Falk 19. So not much of a bite there from Young Remix Killers. But again, this could just be a blimp on the radar as well. But I know the Dark Side would be absolutely stoked that they knocked them over. So well done to you, Milf Hunter. In the next game, Moneymakers 10 took on Team Mazza at Moneymaker Stadium. Moneymakers 10, 110.12. Mazza 96.58. Mazza Train, don't know what's going on with it at the moment. It's sort of up and down like a bride's 90. For Moneymakers, Taylor got 10, Mitchell got 25, Cup got 15, Gallup got 13, and Thielen got 20. For Team Mazza, Wilson got 17, Cook got 11, Robinson 11, Lockett 11, Schultz 14, and Beckham 16. A good return there by Beckham. Odell Jr., but not enough for Team Mazza. Have they derailed again? Fuck, I'd hate to be on their train-fixing fucking crew. They'd be working fucking overtime nearly every week. But well done to the Moneymakers. That's now, what, 6 games in a row that they've won, so we better put a stop to that. In the next game, Mitch's Mongrels, 87.1, beat Shiva Kamini, 81.04. Shiva's now on a 3-game losing streak. Shiva Kamini, Pollard got 27, Hilton 10. They were the only ones that bothered to get... Oh, no, Patriots got 16 as well. They got the double figures. For Mitch's Mongrels, they'll be really happy with this. Mixon got 30 and Dylan got 17. Both players have been hit by injuries and that sort of shit, but the end of the day, you got to put a team out there, and if it's not good enough, it's not good enough. So, well done to you, Mungrel. And in the final game, the Battle of Ballarat, saw Smooth Criminal 85.52 defeat the Browns 85.04. So only 5 yards between these two. The Browns had a really, really big chance on the last day. Alex Collins only needing something like 1.7, and he only scored 1.2. So I'm tipping that the Brown will piss this guy off pretty quickly. Be absolutely fucking spewing. He had his second win in his grasp, and he just let it go. A Smooth Criminal. Cousins got 14. Williams got 10. Allen got 12. Bourne got 20. Hockenson got 11. For the Browns, Wentz got 17, Williams got 18, and Crosby 11, and the Browns' defense got 14. So he'll be fucking spewing that he lost this by 0.48. So let's just run through these again. Rock for Cash beat Archie's All-Stars. The Light beats the Dark. Little River Giants beat Little Waiters in the Little Cup. The Dark Side beat the Killers. Moneymakers 10 beat Team Mazar. Mitch's Mungrels beat Shiva Kamini, and Smooth Criminal beat the Browns in the Battle of Ballarat. So that pretty much wraps up a review of Week 12 of the FNFL. Let's go and have a look at the ladder, see what's happened there. The loss hasn't really knocked Archie's All-Stars off the top. They're still there on 8-4, but now some teams are coming. Darkside 8-4 in second spot. Little River Giants 8-4 in third spot. Moneymakers 10, 8-4 in fourth spot. So we've got four teams on 8-4. A couple of teams on 7-5. Little Waiters in fifth spot. And Young Remix Killers, sixth spot on 7-5. Shiva Kamini, 6-6 in seventh spot. Then we've got three teams on 5-7. Mitch's Mungrels in eighth spot. Team Mazza in ninth spot. And Rock for Cash in 10th spot, 5-7. Smooth Criminal, 4-8 in 11th spot. And the Browns are 1-11, and they're holding up the rest of the teams. So well done, Brown. So that's pretty much it as a review of Week 12. Looking forward to Week 13. Should be some really good games in there as well. Cash will be on later on tonight to do that preview. So have a good one. That's a cash out.